Hello and welcome to Wednesday's Words of Worship. Here we are at Thanksgiving 2020. Now this is traditionally when we make a special effort to pause from our daily routines and give thanks for all the things that we have. Our possessions, our family, our health, our jobs, our faith, and the list could go on and on. Now I remember as a child that in order to be ready for the Thanksgiving meal, someone had to get up in the wee hours of the morning and put the turkey in the oven. You know, this was long before we had programmable appliances or Bluetooth thermometers for our grills and our smokers. The day began very early, and all across the country, kitchens were filled with a whirl of culinary activity, cutting, chopping, peeling. And in between the food preparation, there was the setting of the table and all the decorations to be displayed during the meal. The smell of the turkey, the ham, the dressing, potatoes, green beans, sweet potatoes, cranberry sauce, potato salad, macaroni salad, baked beans, pumpkin pie, cakes, and desserts, all prepared by people I love. I can honestly say that when I was younger, I never truly appreciated all the work that went into making a Thanksgiving meal. And when we lose or don't have appreciation of the value of something, for the time it takes, the energy, the knowledge, and the cost, we cheapen it and we make it mundane, routine, and unappreciated. The Thanksgiving meals that I enjoyed as a child were extraordinary feasts prepared by extraordinary people who are my family. Now, just as we should appreciate the hands that prepare our meals this Thanksgiving, let us also remember the hands that were pierced to provide us with grace. And if we forget the cost, the suffering, and the cross, it makes our grace cheap and unappreciated too. The great theologian and martyr Dietrich Bonhoeffer gave us a warning about cheap grace when he said this: "Cheap grace is the grace we bestow on ourselves. Cheap grace is the preaching of forgiveness without requiring repentance, baptism without church discipline, communion without confession. Cheap grace is grace without discipleship, grace without the cross, grace without Jesus Christ, living and incarnate." So this Thanksgiving, be thankful. Don't get distracted by the foolishness of people thinking they have the right to tell you what to do in your own home. Be genuinely thankful. Be thankful for what we have been given here on this earth and what has been prepared for us when we leave this earth. Hey, I'm Kevin. Thanks for listening. Happy Thanksgiving, and I hope to see you again next week.